Happy New Year, criminals. Welcome back to Batman Arkham Origins. Last time, Mr. Freeze broke into our manor and the Penguin set our shit on fire. This time, we're going to track down the Penguin's arms dealer and figure out, well, just what's going on. At least, that is, after I stop getting distracted by frozen bodies.
They're in temporary cryostasis. I'll need my thermal gloves to safely release them.
I mentioned it in the last video, but I'm going to go around briefly and just kind of tag all these guys that are frozen. They do kind of stick out in detective vision. You can usually see them pretty well through walls, so luckily they're not too hard to track down. Gothcorp here is where Mr. Ferris Boyle actually does business, the People Company. I'm sure we won't be coming back here anytime soon. No, not possible. But yeah, like I said before, having this area kind of locked down to the Diamond District and Coventry, some of the new areas, really gives this DLC a good bit of focus that I feel like may have been missing in the main game. And it's nice to have that focus. It's nice to have, you know, you don't have to cruise through all of Arkham City plus all the new stuff again just to get around. It's, sometimes quantity is not better than quality. And I think that goes for the size of the maps in this game. There's nothing wrong with the map itself, but it's just too big. At least that's my opinion. I've been known to have those.
Come back to help this person once.
Something a little bit of science trivia. Clouds keep the heat in. So on clear days, you've actually got more heat leaving. Some of these thugs are pretty smart. I don't know who they work for. I'm imagining the Penguin, but I don't know. Kind of like Black Mask usually universally recruits a higher class of thug.
Let's make sure there ain't any cops hanging around. The rest of the crew should be showing up any minute.
Ha! Rusty got him good with that.
Freeze ray, cryo gun, what do I do?
She left this one. Hey, what if the cop called for backup before Rusty throws him off?
That's why you let me shut up. Your eyes don't.
So this is sort of an interesting Predator segment, and make no mistake, it is a Predator segment. It's outdoors. And there's no vantage points, nothing like that. So it's an interesting challenge. Trying to figure out just where you need to go to dismantle this is, it's different. I like it. It's not something that I want to see too often, because, man, if used poorly, it can be really irritating. But, for now, I mean, just having it right here, it's not bad. Something else worth mentioning, possibly as a replacement for our freeze grenades or glue grenades, there aren't too many propane tanks in this DLC. Most of them have all been replaced by these cryogenic fluid tanks, which, as you may expect, I had to stop for that thug conversation because I really like it. Basically, it was the Penguin's thugs were talking about, you know, he always carries that umbrella around with him. And what if it's got a gun, or what if it's got a sword, or what if it's got some sort of spiral pattern on it that he spins it and it hypnotizes you. And it all sounds crazy, but those were all things that the Penguin's umbrella did in the Adam West Batman series. And once again, I have to give a lot of credit to Arkham Origins because it does make those old Batman 66 references all the time on all these little small ways, and I love it. Kind of like on the Penguin ship, the final offer, the original name of it was a reference to Burgess Meredith, who was the original actor for the Penguin. It just has all these little things that you may skip over.
She left us one of them.
Hey, what if the cop calls for backup before Rusty throws him up?
Is that a bird?
Nope. So, depending on where you're standing makes this a little bit harder or easier to... Oops.
Let's make sure there ain't any cops hanging. Whoa! Over there.
Huh. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. But I figure I may as well go ahead and show off what these things do. Basically, they act almost exactly like propane tanks, except they're a lot better at just keeping a guy in place. While the guys are frozen, they really can't do anything. They can't attack you, they can't call out, nothing.
Oh, it's you. Let's just pretend that didn't happen.
Whoa!
Steady there.
Of course, you can do your ice smash takedown on them, which I don't get a chance to do this go around, but I'm sure I'll do one sooner or later. And there it is.
Finding Penguin's dealer is the key to finding Freeze. I should scan this area for clues that might tell me where he went. Once Alfred has the XE suit prepped, I'll be able to come back and release this person. Whatever this substance is, it's slowly shutting his systems down, putting him into cryostasis. I won't be able to safely remove him from the ice without the thermal gloves built into the XE suit. The officer just chanced upon Penguin's men. He wasn't equipped to deal with this cryotech, but the cryo gun was leaking. If I hurry, this trail will lead me right to Penguin's men. Then I can make them tell me where this tech came from. Alfred, Penguin's men are using cryogenic weapons to encase innocent people in ice. I'm going to need the thermal gloves and the XE suit to break them free.
I'll get to work immediately, sir. Any idea where these weapons are coming from?
I'll get that answer when I catch up with Penguin's dealer.
So, of course, once again, we have to follow this around and maybe get a little bit distracted by an anarchy tag. And then we'll just go back to following our trail, and should be pretty uneventful. These always are. Gives you a little bit of time to, you know, work out your muscles. Oh. Hello. Well. Uneventful it is. Man, what are the odds? You rob a bank and then there's Batman. That has got to be the worst timing. I mean, the only way that would be worse is if you robbed a bank at which Batman was depositing his money. Just, you know, standing in line. He starts staring as you start staring at you as you walk in with your guns. It's gonna go poorly. For some reason, these guys didn't show up on detective vision as I was walking in. I don't know why.
Don't just stand there, you bums!
Of course, those bombs that Anarchy's crew was setting up and hitting with a baseball bat. Those are gonna stay there all game, so, no big deal. Normally, if I had the ability to, I would go ahead and take care of all the anarchy supporters, just cause, you know, go ahead and get out of the way. But it's not possible to do that at the moment. once we get the XE suit, we'll be able to go ahead and take care of those anarchy protesters, so it's no big deal. I always want to sit here and let these conversations play out, but I guess some of these guys are just really perceptive. So, I'm not skipping these conversations on purpose. These guys are just really good at seeing me. So, I have a problem with the way the cryo guys are implemented. You notice a couple times I just drop my combo after I get a special going and the guy kind of blocks. Just like the martial artists are kind of bugged out when they're fighting Bruce Wayne, these guys seem to be bugged out when you're fighting or trying to use a combo on them from a distance. It's one of the problems I have with this DLC is, you know, they have this new enemy type and it's still a little buggy. But you know, the entire thing still works out really well.
Where's Freeze?
You think I know?
You plan on celebrating the new year in traction?
Okay. He made a deal with Penguin. Weapons in exchange for some stiff. Ferris Boyle. He's in Gothcorp last I saw.
You're lying. Gothcorp doesn't make weapons.
What? No, Gothcorp, I swear. Look, I've got the entry codes.
I'll take those. It doesn't make sense. Gothcorp involved in weapons tech. There's got to be more to this.
The People Company doesn't make weapons. Hey, I'm sure there's nothing to that.
Dispatch 5-5, we got no contact with units on the bridge.
I don't know what a 701 is, but it is probably worth noting that the bridge on both sides is, pretty much frozen over.
I'm scared too.
Really?
Yeah, he's a freaking machine. I'm not dumb enough to think we can take him out.
Maybe we should reconsider our job options.
Whoa. I wouldn't go that far. As long as we play smart, don't draw any attention to ourselves, we should be okay.
I hope you're right.
There you go. The thugs are afraid of the Batman, but, well, maybe not afraid enough just yet.
I love this gun.
Whoa, just watch where you point it. It catches Linden in the crossfire again. I think he's gonna tear your head off.
Right. Sorry. It's just... damn, it's the coolest thing ever.
Well, at least these guys love their job. Worth noting is the disruptor doesn't work on cryo guns, so you just have to go for it.
How many more cops you think?
Something else is that cryo guns will work on anybody. Doesn't matter if they've already got a cryo gun. They'll go ahead and freeze the other guy if they get caught in the line of fire. And that's nice. Cryo guns are one of those things where, if you've got a lot of good spatial perception and you can pay attention very well, you can use it greatly to your advantage to go ahead and kind of pare down the field in terms of people that are trying to fight you. If you're not paying attention that well, what is this graphic? No, it's just frozen over. Yeah. Huh. Neat. They even have textures for that. Anyway. If you're not paying attention, the cryo guns can become, more than a little bit of a threat. Even so, just like the martial arts and the Venom thugs, I like the concept behind it. This DLC does use them enough that they become, they almost outstay their welcome, but not quite.
Dispatch, Air 3, you, there's a wall of ice on Pioneer's Bridge. We got multiple units down. Encased in ice.
See again, Air 3?
Yeah, you gotta see it. We need, I don't know, something.
Air 3, report status of 95 and 73.
Can't confirm, but there are multiple units frozen. Need EMS on scene.
Well, it sounds like things are once again not going well for GCPD. Surprise.
Please, please don't kill me!
As you can see, these guys are also immune to getting caught up in those glide boost takedowns, but that's probably to be expected. And so we find ourselves back at Gothcorp. Who could have seen that coming?
They got a better pair of gloves. My fingers feel like they're gonna snap right off. Yeah. I got a cold that just gets right in your bones. The worst, though, is when you take a breath. And the inside.
Let's go! Someplace. You come on it.
Sure thing, boss.
What are you going to do with me?
You?
Assuming your friend keeps cooperating, I'm sure we won't have to do anything, drastic.
I wanted to do the double-edged takedown, but I guess the other guy just walked a little bit out of range. But, you know, no big deal. This is a combat section, so the guys with guns, not too threatening. You just have to be willing to get in there and mix it up.
Those men were armed. How'd you do that?
Where are they taking Ferris?
Mr. Boyle? They're heading to the propellant research wing. These guys have been raiding the whole facility.
Do you have the codes to this security door?
No, I don't have clearance. But my boss does. A bunch of them took him to the organics lab, through the lobby.
I'll make sure they don't hurt your boss. Get yourself to safety.
This guy's just gonna hang out here. It's no big deal. It makes for a strange moment later. But, no big deal.
I'll come back to help this person once I have my thermal gloves. They're in temporary cryostasis. I'll need my thermal gloves to safely release them.
Of course, we got a couple little exhibits here. I'm gonna go ahead and listen to those.
The Gothcorp Organics Lab is devoted to researching cellular cryogenics implants. Applications of this research include the ability to grow food in inhospitable environments and helps us keep donated organs viable for extended periods. The future is exciting here at the People Company. Is researching new types of supercooled propellants to help launch our country and the world into the future. Whether it's satellite sensors that help farmers manage their crops, or preparing humanity for the colonization of Mars, Gothcorp is on the bleeding edge of cryotechnology for the betterment of humanity. That's why we are called the People Company.
And so with that out of the way, we'll just have to make our way onwards. The security guard told us we needed to go get some security codes, and that should be pretty easy. I don't know what that little noise was when I was passing through. But no big deal. That's a pretty good argument. Whatever. Yeah, I can't argue with that logic.
What is?
Oh.
And that's that. You can definitely tell Guthcorp's got sort of a cryogenics thing going on here. And this is a nice predator room.
So, why so shy all of a sudden, huh?
What happened to that spirit of sharing?
I'm cooperating!
I know, but we all got jobs, see? And my job is to shoot you if I don't think you're telling me the truth.
I told you there are no weapons here. It's just plants. Tissue research.
Yeah, you said.
Then, you believe me?
You know what? I do. I do believe you. But to be honest, I just really love my job.
Oh, God. What is all this junk? Frozen food?
Says it's trying to grow plants at low temperatures.
Ain't they ever heard of global warming?
Mars?
Ain't there enough people starving on this planet? We gotta go feed the Martians now?
So there are two snipers, one of them is armored, one of them is not. If I can go ahead and use this cryo tank, that should make, should freeze both of them at once. I can probably go ahead and take down this sniper, and then I'll go ahead and take out the other one. Should be easy, right? Maybe not. Nah, I got this.
Give me a hand over here.
Unfortunately, doing an ice smash takedown on a jammer thug always gonna be slow. But you can go ahead and take this guy out easy enough. Then we'll just have to make our great escape. And that's gonna go poorly.
Help me kill him.
And I'm gone. So that explosive gel went ahead and knocked off that guy, and not to brag, but I feel pretty good about that one. I thought about tossing down the smoke pellet and go ahead and take down those three guys in the smoke, but one, I don't know if the smoke pellet duration upgrade applies to Cold Cold Heart, and well, you never know, I might need it later. Just in case I'm going to leave another bit of explosive gel there, it doesn't come up. I'll go ahead and spoil that for you now. If you let these guys get far enough along, they will take that security guard hostage, but luckily, they just don't make it that far. Easy enough, right?
Holy crap! I saw you on GNN! You just saved my life!
You have codes I need to access the propellant research wing.
I do. Here, take them. You're going to save Mr. Boyle, right?
It's not safe inside Gothcorp. You need to get out of here.
Don't worry. I won't be hanging around. And, thanks, you know? Not just for me. For Gotham.
And so we've got our security codes. Time to, well, go back to where we came in. There are a couple guys here. I won't be getting them just yet because, well, I still can't. But if you want to get that guy up top, all you have to do is shoot out a quick little tightrope here, and then you can glide over to him. Normally you wouldn't be able to grapple up there. Don't know why. It's not one of those ones you just, for some reason, can't grapple up to, but that's okay. Also, for some reason, dropping off of a zipline just completely freezes all of your forward momentum. You just drop like a rock. Probably something they didn't think of because it didn't happen that often. But I don't know, it happens when you stop using the grapnel mid-swing, so I don't know.
We wait for Fitzy to show.
You know, I can't wait to see you explain this brilliant plan the Penguin's face.
Where's he?
There's a quick fight here. It doesn't take very long. Worth mentioning is there is a set of gun box there. So if you don't want things to get too complicated, you'll probably want to keep that as suppressed as possible. But of course, once you finish the first wave, there's always a second wave. This time with two cryo guys, and we can't just take them out this time.
Don't let him touch you.
Now this is dangerous. See that guy with the little cryo pack that he had in his hands? He wanted to throw at me. If you get caught up in the blast radius of those cryo packs, you will still get frozen. So, it's not one of those things to watch out for. If you're not careful, you can freeze yourself, and it's not too much of a game breaker. It's not gonna kill you if it happens, but it is still something dangerous to look out for. And of course, just as I get over here, these guys start breaking out of their confines. And then this guy's still up there.
My boss has the codes you need. Those goons have him in the organics lab.
The hell, guy? You were right here. You couldn't, you know, shout out a warning or something? How rude. One of the running themes with all the passwords in Gothcorp is they're all very humanitarian-focused. Philanthropy. Stuff like that.
Crazy. Listen, I don't want these guys to be so much. Let's just figure out a way to get in there.
Of course, that door's locked, so we'll have to find a alternate route. Which shouldn't be too hard.
Stage one fueling complete. Docking process initiated.
And by shouldn't be too hard, I mean time for a little bit of platforming. Not much, just enough.
Danger. Temperature anomaly detected in cryo pump 4. Potential breaches in... Danger. Multiple breaches in coolant outtake detected.
This is a nice effect. Whenever you enter these really sub-zero areas, you'll notice, you know, even the screen gets ice caked on it, and Batman's suit also gets a bunch of frozen patches on it. It's just a really nice effect, and I like it. Sometimes I think this DLC had more thought put into it than the main game did.
Give
me boil or I'll freeze this entire room.
Oh, I know you won't. Boyle's got the code you need. And I ain't giving him up, unless I get what he's giving you.
What's behind this door is of no interest to you.
What I'm interested in is the weapons I was promised. I know you're holding out on me.
This will not end well for you.
Oh, I think you're confused about what exactly it's about to happen. As soon as you show us that big fishbowl, my balls will blow it open. And if that goes, I'll be sure to blow your precious tomb right out of Mr. Boyle here's brain.
You've got what was promised.
Getting what I was promised ain't got nothing to do with getting what I want.
I don't want...
To let him go.
Threats are meaningless to a man who has lost everything.
You! This is your fault! You get me out of this!
What's Freeze after? Why does he need Boyle?
Boyle's got codes he needs to access some kind of super weapon. And now you let him have it!
That ice is the only thing saving you from getting the beating you deserve.
Yeah. Look, you ought to save our friend Mr. Boyle, yeah? But you'll never break through this ice. Gothcorp has a device. It's like a drill. A cryo drill.
Tell me where it is.
I had my men bring all our acquisitions to the My Alibi nightclub. For safekeeping, of course.
Then you better hope your men are still at My Alibi. If I want to break through this barrier of ice, I'd better get to the My Alibi nightclub before Penguin's men decide to relocate.
Emergency. Propellant research wing compromised. Initiate evacuation procedures immediately.
You gonna just stand there? I'm gonna freeze to death!
I thought about it briefly. So, I thought about cutting the video here, but there's actually a much better spot coming up. So, bear with me for about another 5 minutes. Should be
warning.
Good.
Critical failure in propellant research wing. Please evacuate.
I can't help this person without the thermal gloves built into the XE suit. Without the XE suit, I'd never survive in that cloud of cryo vapor.
Yeah, so the mist is poison. Don't step in it. Unfortunately, these guys don't have any electric gloves, so now they'll be left here to freeze to death, I guess. Wow. Batman is cruel.
Emergency. Propellant research wing compromised. Initiate evacuation procedures immediately.
They're in temporary cryostasis. I'll need my thermal gloves to safely release them.
And so we find ourselves pretty close to where we started.
I'll come back to help this person once I have my thermal gloves.
You gotta fix this!
What?
I'm no cryo engineer, I'm just...
is the guard?
A freak to death? You better figure it out.
Your friends. He busted the security system on the exit to the lobby.
We can escape.
No one's escaping until we get the Penguin. So I don't care what you are. A guard, an engineer, or a damn snow cone vendor. Fix this situation, or my friends and I are gonna fix you. Understand?
Okay, okay. Just let me think.
Stop! Hold up! Just give me a sec to explain!
That was a terrible explanation. Oh no, Batman, you killed that man. No!
Where'd you come from? That was incredible!
Come with me. I'm getting you out of here.
Thanks for getting me out of there. What are you gonna do now?
After I've recovered the cryo drill, I'm coming back here to save Ferris.
But isn't Freeze gonna try to stop you?
With any luck. Alfred, what's the status of the XC suit?
I've just finished loading it into a drop container.
Good news. I'm on my way to my alibi to recover a stolen cryogenic drill. Have the Batwing drop it there.
It's on its way.
And so there you have it. It is time to get our hands on our new toy.
Outside my alibi. I suggest you secure the area before I initiate the drop.
Well, so, what are we gonna do? Wanna hit a liquor store? Then?
This is the problem with New Year's Eve. You always got such high expectations, and then it's such a letdown.
I think I'm just gonna turn in early. Hey, jeez. When did you become such a crotchety old buzzkill?
Scroll one. More booze and chicks for us.
No booze and chicks tonight. Sorry, boys. I just get stuck in a loop here where I keep getting punched and I don't know what happened. Don't know why I kept doing that. I hate you too, buddy. Where is it? There it is.
The thermal gloves should help you deal with most ice you encounter, sir. And the suit will provide protection. Sir, I suggest you deal with the last of these activists as soon as you're able.
The honeycomb structure insulates against extreme cold without increasing weight. It won't slow me down a bit.
That's gonna be it for this video. Please join me next time when we put our new toy to work.